Okay, we're back. In case you didn't see where the camera cut off, it only takes one hit to beat Eggman. After those four hits that you... before the fight to speed him up. And we're done with Act 3. Well, Zone 3. Oh, if you didn't know, this is the first walkthrough I'm doing while I'm home alone. So I can scream as loud as I want. It's 10:17 right now. And I just want to say, yeah! Woo! I mean, might get a couple looks later about that, but it's all in good fun. Okay, some of these floors, you can't tell, or you probably can tell on camera. See, they kind of move you. I hope you can tell, but you gotta look out for them. Whoops. Hey, give me a ring. There we go. Ow. Just like Palm Tree Panic, just keep going right. There's a spring. Woo! Yeah, it automatically leads you to those springs there if you didn't notice. Oh, that was a close one. Woo! That was quick. I guess you can't do the glitch like you did in the other games. Oh well. You know, where you're off screen and jump on screen and you can screw around. Alright, here we go. Zone 2. Quartz Quandrant. Oh, you know what those past and future signposts that you see? You have to be running constantly. Like, see, I'm glowing right now. And then when you're glowing for a certain amount of time, which means you have to be running for a certain amount of time, you then change the time period. I guess you go so fast that you travel in time or something. Well, the planet that you're on, I think, if I recall on the storyline, the planet's timeline is going out of control because of Eggman, so... hence why you can go back and forth through time so easily. Well, technically it wouldn't be easy for the average man to do so. Hey, I wasn't supposed to get caught there. Because, you know, they don't have Sonic speed. There's an extra life down here. Woohoo! It's gonna take me to the future. Because I was glowing enough. You can cancel it all if you want to by simply stopping. But I don't know, it's just kind of fun to switch between times. Don't you just love the music in this game? It's awesome, I think. In my opinion. Every single level, I just love the music in. Hey, I love this game, what can I say? Act 3! There's extra life up here, if you didn't know. Go through here. And jump up here. Okay, this is a really easy boss. Just watch. Hit him first. And now you have to run against the treadmill. See, it causes friction on the bottom of Eggman's pod or whatever. And then he's gonna try and throw spike balls to bug you. But just stop. And jump between the top... between the middle two, just like this. Keep repeating and you'll be able to do this zone very quickly. I should say this boss. So yeah, the treadmill underneath my feet's causing friction because I'm making it go faster by running. I don't know if you can tell. I think you can. It's very cool. Look at him panicking. Ah, stop it. I think this is the last one. There we go. Woo! Yeah, that's all you have to do for the boss. The bosses in this game are really creative because a lot of them, you don't have to hit the boss like you normally do. You know, you have to keep attacking him, attacking him. It's usually just about getting through the obstacle, figuring out the puzzle, which makes this level even, I mean, makes this game even more unique. Well, this is Wacky Workshop now. Because of these floors, you're gonna have trouble controlling yourself. Now, basically what you wanna do is stay as low as possible because, oh shoot, because up here is little platforms that that springy floor will lead you to. So try and stay on the... Ah, oh, hey, stop that. There, that's what those platforms do. Or, I mean, the bottom floor does. Is that it tries to lead you... Oh, whoa! Into dead ends. I try not to get there, but it does it to me anyway. It's just the nature of this level. You have to be a pro speedrunner to be able to not hit the floor every time. It's very safe to just jump on each platform you see along the way, but it's just more fun to just run through it. After all, it's a Sonic game, why be careful? Hey, let me down, okay. Tiny GameCube D-pad? Oh shoot. I want to land on a platform, thank you. Let's see, there we go. Oh no. Okay. No! Oh shoot. I hate that floor! Okay, keep going down. Yeah, normally I say up, but it's actually down in this game. Who would have guessed? Okay, we're past that part. Oh shoot, didn't want to hit that. Oh, watch out for these things, they're electrocuted. See these things in the background? This is only in the future though. I think it's only in the future. It's gonna... Oh, okay, I made it. Looks wrong way. I'll eventually make it back down there. There's a platform right there. Oh shoot. Made it. Done. Yeah, these zones can be kind of tricky, but they're fun to bounce around, even if they keep leading you into dead ends. You'll figure it out eventually. Just stay low so that you're under those barriers that lead you to dead ends, but not touching the floor, because that'll spring you up to the top. Woo! Oh, wait. Ow. I did that on purpose that time. Oh, okay. Hey, there we go. Don't want that platform, I want this one. And this one. And the spring. There we go. Levels in this game can get pretty confusing at times, if you didn't notice. But that's also what adds to the fun and appeal of this game. It's not simply about getting to the end of the stage, it's about finding your way to the end of the stage. I mean, I guess that's... Oh! Hey! Stop that! Yeah, those beams freeze you. Like other games, sure, you have to get to the end of the stage a certain way. But this one's is like a maze of awesomeness. That's the only way I can describe it.